Hello and welcome to Healthy Pets, Healthy Lives. My name is Brian Pinto. I am the Chief Advancement Officer for Humane Pennsylvania and the Humane Society of Berks County. And this show is going to focus all on animal adoption, and it's going to focus on issues that affect pets and their caregivers in Berks County. With me tonight are two very special guests. We have with us Leann Quire, our Director of Shelter Operations. And Leann, who did you bring with you tonight?
I have Gio, our little three-year-old Yorkshire Terrier.
Wonderful. Well, welcome, Gio. You are going to be a star tonight.
Yes.
And we are going to get to you in just a second, Gio. We'll ask you some very important questions. but before we start, Leann, I always like to open the show by getting behind the guest and to have the guest tell their background and let the viewers out there get to know you for a little bit. So I know for a fact that you are a Berks County native.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And what was it that got you interested in animals? Did you have animals growing up in your house?
Yes. My parents were both animal lovers, and that just went on, you know, to my generation.
Did you have dogs and cats in your house?
Dogs, cats, critters, always had turtles that we found crossing the road, and ferrets, all different zoos of animals.
Wonderful. So now, how did you happen upon the Berks County Humane Society?
So it's actually a really cool story. I went to Exeter High School, and I knew since I was little I wanted to be a veterinarian. And they offered a co-op program where half of the day during high school you could go and volunteer in a job that was similar to the field that you eventually wanted to get into. So they worked with the Humane Society. So when I was about 16, I think, I went and did the co-op program. And so I started as a volunteer back 10 years ago, 11 years ago now.
That's quite some time ago.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so you started volunteering.
Yep.
At the animal shelter. What were some of the things that you were doing then?
Scrubbing walls, helping to paint, lots of cleaning tasks that were very, very important. but, you know, I was a volunteer and I was very young, so I was doing a lot of kind of the, you know.
So there were some things that you were only allowed to do and other things that you probably couldn't do at that time because of age.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Wonderful. So from volunteering at the Humane Society of Berks County, how did you become Director of Shelter Operations?
Right, that's a big jump.
Yeah.
So being a volunteer was great because it got me, you know, my foot in the door. It got me to know the staff that was there, some that are still there today. And they saw my, you know, fantastic work scrubbing walls and painting doors.
And those walls have never been cleaner, let
me
tell you.
That's right. Yeah. And they then asked me, you know, if I wanted a position. I was like, of course. So I worked then as a kennel tech where I got a little bit more hands-on interaction with the animals. It's where I started to do adoptions. And so as I graduated high school and started my college career, I was working weekends, holidays, and then summers when I was back home.
So even while you were in college, you were still connected to the Humane Society of Berks County because you went to York College.
York College of Pennsylvania.
Okay, and when you were there, you studied?
Biology. And
so you're a pretty smart one. My hats are off to anybody who studies the sciences. It's majored in English, and sometimes I have trouble completing sentences.
Yeah.
So I salute you and all the work that you've been doing. This is just wonderful. Mm-hmm. So what does the Director of Shelter Operations do?
Mm-hmm. So, goodness, that's a big question.
That's a big question. What is it that you were in charge of?
I mean, ultimately, I oversee and make sure that the shelter runs properly.
Mm-hmm.
So that involves overseeing a lot of staff members, you know, from the kennel technicians that are taking care of the animals and making sure they have what they need to, you know, the coordinators that, you know, help with the volunteers, that help coordinate the staff members that are, you know, helping the animals, the front desk staff. And that's at two different locations I do that.
You do that at both of our shelters,
right.
The Humane Society of Berks County and the Humane League of Lancaster County, which is no small task.
No.
I know all your dedication and your staff at both shelters are some of the most dedicated people I have ever met.
I could not do what I do without them. Is for sure. Yeah,
absolutely. Mm-hmm. Well, we want to get to know Gio
sure.
a little bit.
Who's
now.
Falling asleep.
Oh my gosh, I have a tendency to put people to sleep too, so that's okay. So tell us a little bit about Gio.
Sure.
He is a three-year-old
Yorkshire Yorkshire Terrier. He only came into us a couple days ago. Okay. The owners were unfortunately moving, and where they were moving to, they couldn't take animals with them. So he came to us and immediately settled in with us, loved everybody.
Well, he's settled in right now, too. This is wonderful.
Yes.
My gosh.
Now, he did just have surgery early this morning, but he got the clear. He was good to come tonight, but he was neutered, which is a testament to how wonderful our veterinary staff is. Earlier, you saw he was bouncing off the walls.
He was pretty energetic earlier. Right. I'm surprised how much he's settled into this TV show right now.
I think he just got his wiggles.
We're talking about you.
But he lived with other dogs, and they said he loved the other dogs and did really well with them. He didn't live with cats before, and Yorkshire Terriers are sometimes known to like to chase small things. So not that I would say he has to go to a home without cats, but I do think it would need to be somebody educated and prepared to slowly introduce them and supervise, just because we don't know how he would do.
How would he react with a cat? What about children of all ages? Is he good with?
He didn't live with children, but they said that when he would be around them, he did okay. They said he definitely preferred adults, just because they weren't constantly grabbing, touching, and picking him up. Yeah. However, I must say, I was, you know, just with how cute he is, I'm like, oh, Gio,
who doesn't want to cuddle you?
Right.
Oh my gosh,
very
Gio.
Similar to children, and he did great with it. So I mean, I really think if the right family comes along, and you know, with the guidance of our adoption technicians, I think he could be a really good dog. And
well,
Gio
is currently up for adoption, like many pets that we have at the Humane Society of Berks County. So if someone is out there watching and they think that they can't live another day without little Gio here,
the one.
What do they do? What is the process when someone walks through the door and says, hi, I'm here to adopt?
Sure. So the first thing that we have them do is fill out an adoption application. It's 2 pages. You know, it doesn't take very long, but it really gives our counselors good insight and background to what their lifestyle is like at home. What do they already have in the home?
Like what hours do they work?
Right,
are
they how busy
home on
their
weekends?
Household is. Yeah. You know, if there's children in the home already, if there's animals in the home already, really important things that help us to do our job of matchmaking them with the animal that they're looking for. So they'll fill that out. That also helps us to, you know, verify certain things to make sure that the animals are going to good homes. You know, it helps us to see if there are any red flags or things that would be concerns that we can either discuss and address, you know, or maybe says this isn't, you know, the right person for this dog. But once the counseling is through and, you know, we have a pretty good feel for what they're looking for, we will then have them meet the dog with one of our technicians.
Okay.
And that's when they'll go more in depth about the animal, what the animal's background is, if we have it. Sometimes they're strays.
Not always easy to have that information. So,
absolutely. Yeah. But the technicians do a really good job of getting to know the animal and their personality while they're in the shelter. So they'll talk about what we've observed, what the previous owner has observed, and what they've, you know, experienced. We'll tell them about the medical history and background, and just, again, try to do the matchmaking, because a lot of people come in and, you know, they really think that they
want. They think they know what they want.
Right.
But in reality, if the pet's temperament isn't exactly matching to their lifestyle, then.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I always say that, you know, we trust us that we're the professionals and we know these animals. We will trust you to know your household and, you know, what goes on there. But
exactly.
Let's work together to, you know, make a good match.
So is it a must that if there are other animals within the household that they bring those animals in to meet the potential adoption?
No. I mean, there are certain cases where we do, you know, if it's a dog that, you know, maybe we're not quite sure how they do and we really think it would be best, but we'll specify that right up front. We do not allow cats to be brought into the shelter to be introduced to other cats or dogs, just because cats are different than dogs.
Yeah, they are.
They are very stressful creatures, and we don't want to stress them out any more than they have to. So our technicians are fantastic about educating the owner on how to introduce those animals. We do allow dog introductions. They are not required, again, unless it's a certain situation. But we do try to, you know, go over things very thoroughly with the person that's bringing their dog in to make sure that they understand what we're seeing, but also understand that this is a very small, you know, snippet of what could be to come. And
exactly.
So,
there's going to be a lifetime of love to give an animal.
Right.
So you don't you're not always able to capture everything
exactly.
in that moment.
Exactly.
Yeah. If there are other people living in the household, mm-hmm. do you require that they come to meet the mm-hmm. pet?
We really encourage it. And yeah. again, in certain situations, we do require it. With mm-hmm. certain dogs, we will require the children to, you know, come in and meet just to see how, you know, they interact with the animal. And so we can
sure.
use that time to do education. But it's not always mandatory, but we do really encourage it just because you know, everybody needs to fall in love and
absolutely.
Be on board yeah. with that, you know, decision. Yeah.
So when it looks like the adoption is a go,
yep.
what is included with the adoption fee that the customer pays for
right.
the pet?
A lot, actually.
Okay.
It's a really good deal for what we have. So all of the dogs, cats, and rabbits at the shelter go home sterilized, so spay and neutered before
excellent.
They go home. They are all microchipped.
Mm-hmm.
They are up to date on what vaccines they can have. So that typically includes a rabies vaccine, a distemper vaccine, dewormer.
Okay.
For dogs, a Bordetella, which tries to prevent the kennel cough virus.
Sure.
And you know, anything again that they're able to get up to that point. We also offer a healthcare supplement with our veterinary hospital.
Which is located right next door
right
to the Humane
door.
Society,
yep,
so
convenient.
It's very easy to get there.
Exactly.
Okay.
And basically, what that means is within 30 days of adoption, they get a, basically the fee to see the vet is waived, and then certain treatments are discounted, again, within that
excellent.
First 30 days and only at, you know, our hospital.
Very good. What are some of the qualifications that we might look for a potential adopter? Is it a must that they own their own home?
Mm-hmm. Nope, we do.
So if they rent?
Adopt to renters, yeah.
Okay.
Now they have to know their pet policy.
There you go.
And there are times that we will reach out to verify that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's very important because we don't want even the adopter to fall in love and, you know, go home. And
it could be heartbreaking if it doesn't work out because of a regulation.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yep, within 48 hours bringing them back. It's stressful to the animal, it's stressful to them. So yeah that's part of the... when we talk with the adopter about, you know, background, that's
sure.
definitely one of the things that we
sure.
touch on.
That's one thing that I wanted to touch on just briefly, and it's such a horrible thing to mention, but every once in a while it doesn't work out.
Right.
And so approximately what percentage might be returned because the adoption just doesn't work
right.
out with situations?
Thankfully, it's not very high.
My
estimate, and it can fluctuate, you know, year to year and
yeah.
Depending on different circumstances, but my estimate is anywhere between 5% to 7%
okay.
is return. Now, that can be from so many different reasons.
Yeah.
You know, luckily, it usually isn't, you know, because they weren't able to adjust because our technicians do a really good job.
Right. Absolutely.
But sometimes things don't just, you know, work out. And as much as the counseling that we give is thorough and we try to,
yeah.
you know, be extensive, sometimes
you're
you
gonna
just don't know.
You're going to get adopted so soon. I can just tell. Oh, my gosh,
he's
Gio.
A cutie.
You are a heartbreaker.
Uh-huh.
So anyone who is interested in Gio, can they find his photograph on our website? He's not on yet because,
okay. like I said, he was neutered,
he was just neutered.
Just this morning.
Okay.
So this is kind of like a, you know,
this is his
sneak
debut.
Yeah.
yeah.
He will be available, though, first thing tomorrow. Our doors open at 9. Adoptions typically start at 10 o'clock.
Okay.
So first thing tomorrow, our staff members will get a cute picture of him, get him on the website. But
excellent.
Honestly, with him, I have a feeling he might get adopted before we even get it up.
I think you're right on the money there. But our website is humanepa.org,
yep.
and we've got photographs of all the adoptable
yes.
animals, be it cats or dogs or, mm-hmm. or little critters.
And we have lots of little critters right
now. What kinds of critters do we have right now?
We have a lot of hamsters. We
oh,
have
okay.
a gerbil. We have rabbits. We have a guinea pig.
Wow.
And we just adopted out a bunch of lizards, but we did have all different kinds of lizards as well.
That's pretty neat.
Yes.
Not bad. So what gets adopted the fastest? What is the easiest animal to get to a home?
Usually kittens.
Yeah, the
puppies,
cute cuddly.
Yep, small dogs
yeah,
definitely go pretty
yeah.
quick, especially because a lot of places do have size, you know, restrictions.
Sure.
So the small ones do go quickly. So that, you know, is why we, you know, adjust our adoption fees based on their adoptability, because we want the senior animals to have a chance as well. So our senior prices are very affordable, but we're able to do that because of, you know, highly adoptable animals like Gio.
And what are our average prices for animals?
So again, it really all depends on the cat,
the breed and such.
Right, but for a dog, I mean, it can go anywhere up to $300 being a very, you know, adoptable puppy, but that includes all the things we talked about. Microchip, spay and neuter, the discounted vet care, all of that. Now, Gio is up for adoption for $225.
Okay. And when someone is looking to adopt, are there certain supplies that they should already have? Mm-hmm. And if they don't have those supplies, how can they go about getting them?
Yeah, so we do require our dogs to leave with a leash and collar.
Okay.
We do sell them at the shelter, and the brand that we sell is actually Good for Life. So
excellent.
Very, you know, common for dogs to, you know, get a hold of them and use them as a tug toy and chew them up. So if that happens, they, you know, they're good. They don't have to buy a new one. They can bring their own leash and collar. That's fine. But we do, you know, suggest talking to a technician before getting one, just because you don't want to spend the money and not have it fit properly.
Right.
But other things, like for a dog, a crate, we always talk about crate training for a new dog that who knows what their previous life has been, you know, so having really good supervision and help with housebreaking as far as a crate training is good. We sell them. Food and water dish, toys are very important.
Oh, of course.
Very important.
Yes.
You know, dog beds, things like that. But we do sell those things at the shelter.
Wonderful.
So even if you come, you know, with nothing, we can guide you and help you get the, you know,
all the supplies that someone would need.
Exactly.
That's wonderful. Well, now there's one point that I did want to bring up, and it's something that I've seen on our website before. I think it's very important for people to know. Mm-hmm. It's about the free to a great home program that we offer for some animals.
Yes.
Can you talk about that?
Sure. So that, I love that program. Animals that have been at the shelter up for adoption more than 60 days qualify, as well as certain animals that we deem that need maybe the extra help as far as if they have extra medical things going on that makes them not as adoptable.
Sure.
Or if it is, you know, an older animal that, again, has been sitting, we will waive their adoption fee to try to encourage them to get some extra, you know, attention on them. And it's been very helpful. It's literally saved animals' lives.
That's a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
That's great.
What it's all about.
And speaking of free adoptions, we just came off of a free adoption weekend that occurred last Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And
very
we
successful.
Adopted out 54 animals. That's wonderful.
It is so wonderful, especially this time of year.
Wow.
We are definitely in our busy season right now. The shelter was packed, you know, to the max.
Wow.
And having 54 animals go home is just...
That's a beautiful thing right there.
Yes.
So with 54 animals having gone home, are the shelters empty now, or do they fill up immediately?
Unfortunately, they're not empty.
Yeah.
This time of year, I mean...
That would be our dream come true if we never had to do this again.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It felt empty compared to how it normally does. I walked in today, and I mean, we had one dog on the adoption floor.
Wow.
You know, the cats were a little bit more full, but still seeing empty cages.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, again, this time of year is busy, so I suspect by the weekend we will have our cages full again, unfortunately.
Full again.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And one thing that I think would be very neat for people to do is if they come to the Humane Society of Berks County and they find their new best friend, for example, Gio right here, there is an event coming up this Saturday.
Yes.
We've got some paraphernalia here on the table here. It's called Pints for Pups.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a great event where people can bring their new best friend or their old best friend with them. Saturday, July 22nd at Jim Dietrich Park in Muhlenberg Township. Mm-hmm. It is from 5 to 8 p.m. It is a dog-friendly beer tasting event, which is pretty darn cool.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody who attends and wants to participate in the tasting of beer gets a cool pint glass like this, and some people even get a t-shirt. We'll have t-shirts there for sale, and it's just a wonderful day with great food, great music, family-friendly events.
Always so much fun.
A lot of fun, and a lot of cute dogs always end up coming there, too.
Which makes it even better.
And so if anybody wants to buy tickets to Pints for Pups, they can visit our website at humanepa.org and click on the button that says Shop Our Store at the top, and you can get your tickets there. General admission is only $40, and VIP is $75. With VIP, you do get your glass and a t-shirt. General admission just includes the glass. So we hope everybody comes out for Pints for Pups this year.
Absolutely.
Because the dollars that are generated from these events
go to Geo.
Exactly. Go to help little guys like Geo find homes. Yeah. And that's what it's all about for us here at the Humane Society of Berks County.
Right.
So, Leann, in your mind, if money were no object, aside from the great events that we can produce to assist pets like Geo find homes, what's needed? What does the Humane Society of Berks County need?
Sure. So there's always the common things that we're going to need day in and day out. The, you know, cat food, dog food, and that's dry and wet.
Those types of supplies are crucial.
Absolutely. Yeah. Washable toys. And I say washable just because it is helpful if we can wash them. That helps it to go a long way.
Exactly.
But any toys, honestly, we'll take and we'll use. But a lot of things that people don't really realize that we need at the shelter, and it really does help the animals. Office supplies. We go through paper like crazy.
That's a surprised me when I first got to the Humane Society was how much paper we need to have on hand for all the adoption applications and all the paperwork that is associated with an adoption.
Yes.
That's pretty big.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And if we don't get that donated, you know, we need it. We need to do it to make sure the process happens. So, you know, that's, we rather have it donated so the extra money can go to animals like Geo.
Sure.
Cleaning supplies. Mm. We go through Windex like crazy.
Oh,
you need to be able to see the animals that are up for adoption.
That'd be helpful. Yeah.
And you don't want to see those smudges. So different cleaning supplies is always, you know, a big help.
Laundry detergent.
Laundry detergent.
Bleach
is huge, absolutely. And I mean, again, things that people don't really think of, gardening supplies, you know.
Holy cow,
you know, outside look nice. Come spring, we're always looking for donation of, you know, flowers and mulch and, you know, soil to make the outside look pretty and inviting.
And we've got a wish list on the website that's always updated on a continuum.
Yes, as well as the Amazon, which people can purchase things from our Amazon wish list, and it goes right to us. It is
fantastic.
That's pretty
easy. Yeah.
It's very easy for us to update when we need things that, you know, pop up as needed with reptiles that come in, and we need reptile bulbs or pooper scoopers. And
you never know what you're going to need on any day, depending on what comes into
the
shelter. Now, speaking of what comes into the shelter, what are some of the reasons why people tend to relinquish their pets to a shelter?
Right. There's a lot of really common ones. Just like Geo, moving is a big, big one, especially when people have to downsize and move to apartments. A lot of places do have restrictions. So we see that, and that's pretty heartbreaking because you can tell a lot of people are in situations they can't really do anything about. Allergies are a big thing. Issues with other animals. So if there's, you know, dog to dog issues or dog to cat, new babies coming in the household are a big one as well. Those are the common ones. And then there's always the things that, you know, just kind of pop up in special circumstances. But we're here for everybody.
Absolutely.
If somebody can't care for an animal, that is why we're here, is to help with that.
Absolutely. And we have programs in place that we try to make people aware of to prevent the relinquishment of their pets to the shelter as well. One of my favorites, just because of the title, is Animeals. I think that's a cool name. Can you describe that program?
Yeah, Animeals is basically a food bank that helps lower income families or people just going through a hardship that are struggling to feed themselves, let alone their pets. And there are a lot of people out there that will feed their pets before them. But we want to make that a little bit easier, and we, you know, don't want an animal to be surrendered because the owner wasn't able to feed them.
Exactly.
So they have to qualify. They have to sign up and go through that process. But once they are approved, we can assist them monthly with getting food so they don't have to bring their pet in.
Excellent. And now I know there is a foster care program as well. Can you describe that for us?
Yes, I'm glad you brought that up because it is kitten season and we need
fosters.
But our foster program is great. It is life-saving. We provide everything, food, the supplies, the vet care. The only thing, you know, we won't take care of is your transportation to get, you know, to us and back to your home.
Okay.
But otherwise, it's a great program that usually involves kittens.
Sure.
You just playing with kittens.
How about that? That's not such a bad gig.
No.
Yeah. Very nice. So, and so a lot of times, a lot of these supplies that people are donating are going to go to, A, the animals in our shelter, but also those animals who are in foster care, or some of the food that they donate is going to help our Animals program to sort of pay it forward to other Berks County families. So these are some wonderful programs that we have to offer the community that maybe a lot of people just aren't aware of.
Right.
If you were to look into a crystal ball, and to try to guess what the future of animal welfare is going to bring the Humane Society of Berks County. What do you think that might look like?
Oh, goodness, again.
That's a big
very
question.
Very big question. Yeah. But I think I focus on a couple big things as far as education, mm-hmm. Involvement with other organizations, and I think legal-wise, I think the not just Pennsylvania, but everywhere is really starting to crack down and get better with animal abuse laws.
And, yeah,
right.
Exactly.
And so I see that, and again, mixed with just education and, you know, helping to get the word out there about programs like the ones we just talked about to prevent, you know, animals from having to come to the shelter that don't have to.
And maybe sometime in the future we'll see some additional renovations occur to the actual Humane Society
yes.
building itself too. So
yeah.
that'll be something that we'll be focusing on in the future as well.
Absolutely.
You know, the bottom line is we couldn't do what we do without people like you, without your staff, mm-hmm. without our volunteers. What do volunteers do for us day in and day out? You spoke a little bit about that in the beginning.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Volunteers are great. We use volunteers for every aspect in the shelter, from maintenance to dog walking to administrative work.
There's a little bit of something for
everyone. If you have an interest, yeah, we can find something for you, and we always need volunteers.
Absolutely. And again, people can go to our website
yes.
if they'd like to find out more information on volunteering
yep.
at the Humane Society. Again, that's humanepa.org. And as we close with this edition of Healthy Pets, Healthy Lives, I want to thank all of you for tuning in to us. And Leann, I also want to thank you for being my special guest. And little Gio, oh my gosh, you were so well behaved. We are going to find you a home very, very soon.
Yes.
I have a feeling that adoption is not going to be too difficult
no,
for you.
No, not at all.
At all. Well, again, Leann, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you for
appreciate
having
it. And Gio, you keep the faith, and we're going to find you a home real soon.
Yep, absolutely.
So go to our website, humanepa.org. We're going to get Gio's picture loaded up as soon as possible tomorrow morning, and I think there might be a line waiting at the front door mm-hmm. to adopt him as well. You're a good boy. Yes, you are. He was so well behaved.
He was good.
During all this time,
very
too.
Proud of him.
Very good. Very well done,
He's
Gio.
He's going to have a good nap tonight.
Absolutely. He'll get a good rest, and we'll see you next time. Thanks so much. Wow.